In his autumn for the winter comes man's last mad surge of youth.
What on earth are you talking about?
This is the voice of Inkbuck Relay Automatic. In and for the planet you of the Earth called Jupiter, on behalf of the honorable representative Cortan, we are ready to begin with that information which we have in our records at this time.
He's got the whole wide world. filed, stamped, indexed, briefed, debriefed, or numbered.
The first major band that I was in, was The Chameleons. I was playing in a punk band called The Clichés, and Dave and Reg, who I went to school with, had a band of their own, and they saw me playing The Chameleons and immediately wanted to form a new group, which we did, and that became The Chameleons. Within 6 months of that, we were on John Peel, and then our lives changed. So that was the first major band that I was in. Initially, it was just me and Dave Fielding and Red Smithers, and we had a session drummer for the Peel session that we hired called Brian Schofield. But then when things took off, we needed a permanent drummer, so we auditioned. That would be about 1982, early 82. And that's when John turned up. Then we met John, and that's when that became the set of the lineup of the Chameleons.
Thank you.
First major album release was actually on an independent label called Static Records. We were with CBS initially, and then when we told them we wanted to do the album at Abbey Road, they fired us. and we ended up on Static Records, a little indie label in London, and that was who we made Script of the Bridge for. Script of the Bridge come from? It came from something a friend of ours said one night. We were all on acid, wandering around the North Manchester countryside, and we crossed a motorway bridge, and we were all tripping out of our skulls. And my friend Ken, I don't think he'd done acid before. It might have been his first time. I think it was. And he was just goggle-eyed, looking at all the traffic that was going underneath this bridge. It was kind of like a Steven Spielberg movie with the lighting. And he just turned around to us and said, you know, what's the script with this bridge? And Tony just went, script of the bridge. And I wrote it down in a notebook. So when we wanted a title for the album, that's where I looked in my notebook and I saw that and I thought, perfect.
What on earth are you talking about?
Pretty much what every song I've ever written is about, in one form or another, and that's alienation. I mean, there are some direct themes on Skirts of the Bridge that deal with, you know, direct themes like violence, for example. You know, with a person isn't safe, or, you know, keeping your shit together in adversity, like Don't Fall. But basically, all of the songs that I write are about a feeling of alienation that I've always experienced my whole life and still do.
Shake your hands, feel your legs, I can make that change. And all I say is good, make my ears, I can handle it. I can call on a friend, remember the faces you wore at school. Making the madness of solitary sadness, a friendly fool.
I will not be pushed, filed, stamped, indexed, briefed, debriefed, or numbered.
What other albums followed Script of the Bridge? Well, we did What Does Anything Mean, basically, which I didn't enjoy. It was more of a... we only made it to get out of the contract, you know. We were at this label and we were wrangling with them for such a long time. And then in the end, some people came in and negotiated on our behalf. And they said, well, if they give us another record, we'll let them go. So we gave them that. So that's the reason why there's a lot of really quite older songs on it. I think there's only like a couple of songs on that record that were recent to the time. The rest of them were songs that didn't make Scripts of the Bridge for one reason or another. So we didn't want to give him too many new songs. So that was There Was Anything Mean, basically. And then we signed to Geffen and we did Strange Times, which I personally enjoyed. I thought it was the best writing that I'd turned in for the band.
We'll be right back.
that was it then. We were making the fourth album when we split up. I've made a lot of albums in between. I mean, not a lot, but I've made quite a few albums in between on my own and with other people. I did an acoustic-y kind of record called Zima Junction, which seems to go down very well.
Sits in awe. shelf. Devil's bait. Way beyond the sell-by date.
I did an album for Steve Harrison at Dead Dead Good Records with Paradigm, which is the first time I wrote with, first time I worked with Eve. Eve was the producer, although he's credited as a songwriter, and that was, he didn't actually write it. The songs were written already, but he had such a massive input, I included him on the songwriting.
I've spent a lot of years now
And then I did the Invincible record with Eve, which I really love, which hardly anybody's got, because you know, only a few hundred went out, I think. Yeah, so I, you know, I've done a few records. So.
Soundtrack, but all I did was look at you. could still be friends, I said. I knew I'd lost you then forever.
My own. I am not a number. I am a person.
I was digging for water. had to fight tooth and nail, really, to retain what essentially we're all about. And
what on earth are you talking about?
So they're getting something that the group has created. It's not manufactured for a market. We don't think people as record market, you know what I mean? Which is like, and to be able to retain that, we're fighting really tooth and nail, because of course the labels want to get involved to the extent where they want to make us a commodity, but we're more than a commodity, you know, we're an exercise in communication. It means that we won't pursue a hit record to the detriment of everything else that we do, basically. It means that if loads of people suddenly hear one of our songs and they go out and buy it in droves, that's great. But we won't pursue that and prostitute other areas of what we do for the sake of having a record in the top 10. The whole idea is totally abhorrent. And really, I mean, you shouldn't have to do that anyway.
Surge of youth.